يا ويحهم ماذا جنوا وتأفكوا وأتوا بقول الجاهل الفتان. ورأيت منهم أرعنا يدعو إلى سحر يحل به لدى الكهان. ورأيت منهم تافها يدعو إلى حل المعازف والغنى الشيطان.
الحمد لله مجيب من دعا وفاتح الباب لعبده إن قرأ إذ قوله أمن يجيب مضطر إذا دعا. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمر واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. أما بعد, frequent calamities and turbulence, one needs to look at himself. He may be sinning, he needs to return back to Allah and repent, or it may be a test, so he needs to be patient. A lot of question has been thrown on me saying I'm doing everything but nothing is materializing, nothing is working, or I get better 2 days and then I relapse into total chaos the third day. Right, this question will answer it in 2 answers. Number one is either you're sinning, you need to repent and return back to Allah, repent frequently. 2 is either the devil who has been sent or who is there is strengthening whatever he's doing. So you need to up your game or stay steadfast and don't worry what is going on. Don't lose hope. I'm going to give you 6 tips. These tips will help you overcome whatever you're going through by the will of Allah. Now, whether you have a problem of possession or you don't have a problem of possession or magic, but this is in general, it's very, very good to do it. Point number one is sending blessings towards the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Whoever is worried or has got any other problem, let him send blessings to the message of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah Rabbul Izza says in the Quran, a'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim, bismillahir rahmanir rahim, inna Allaha wa malaikatahum yusalluna 'alan nabi, ya ayyuhalladhina amanu sallu 'alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allah commanding the believing men and women to send blessing to the message of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Whoever is looking for peace and tranquility and his daily life to be stable and be forgiven and his worries be lifted, let him send salutations. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Point number 2 is dua. Dua. Allah wants to hear from you. So make dua in abundance, oh you Muslims. Hold tight into this ibadah of frequently calling upon Allah, whether you're distressed or not distressed. Dua is very, very important. Whoever makes dua abundantly, this is a form of ibadah. Not everyone is being given. And Abdullah bin Mas'ud radiallahu anh said the dua is the highest level of ibadah. So whoever is engaged in calling upon Allah frequently, Allah will answer his call. Because Allah says in the Quran, A'udhu billahi min shaitan rajim, bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Qul idu'u Allah aw idu'u ar-Rahman. Call upon Allah, call upon the most merciful, the most gracious. So call him frequently. And Allah Rabbul Izzah says again in the Quran, A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim, bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Wa qala rabbukum ud'uni astajibu lakum. He says, call upon me and I will answer your call. So you have to have certainty and yaqeen and iman, and your tawheed needs to be correct, not dodgy tawheed, for you to know that Allah will answer your dua. Do not be haste. I made dua, no one is, you don't have to do that. Call and you have to be patient. Point number 3 is gratitude. Showing gratitude no matter what situation you are in, show gratitude. Allah Rabbul Izzah says in the Quran, مَا يَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ بِعَذَابِكُمْ إِن شَكَرْتُمْ وَآمَنْتُمْ. What will Allah do with his punishment if you show gratitude and believe? So show gratitude in abundance if you are possessed. If you are not possessed, say Alhamdulillah. إِنَّ لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّ إِلَيْهِ رَاجْعُونَ. Everything will go back to Allah Rabbul Izzah. So show gratitude. Gratitude is very, very important to have. Point number 4. Is charity. Charity is very, very important. Charity has been documented in the Sunan. A lot of hadith talking about charity. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Dawu maradakum bis sadaqa." Cure or treat your sick through charity. Charity, it's very, very important. Remember, whatever you have that does not belong to you, you can leave it any minute. Allah Rabbul Izzah is the one who's given you and he's mighty. So give a lot. and see what will it do to you. It will help you today and it will help you on the akhirah. If you are worried too much, give chorit and don't even say that I've given chorit. Just keep it between you and Allah Rabbul Izzah. So give charity in abundance. I've got a story of mine, I'm going to share it. One of my brother, he's a sheikh, and his sheikh narrates to him, says, I had a daughter of mine who was very ill, and I took her to the hospital. It was a private hospital. And the private hospital, there was a massive queue. I have to pay the reception and waited in the queue. When I look at my daughter, she's deteriorating. And I went to the reception and begged the first time. They didn't allow me. Says the queue is big. The second time, they did not allow. The third time, they did not allow. And the hadith of the Messenger of Allah come to his mind. I just quoted, Dawu marzakum bis sadaqa. And he asked for his money back. He took his money. He went out looking for a poor person. And he found one. He gave the money to that. And he left all the way back to home. The minute he reached home, his daughter got cured. That is the extent of charity. So, oh, you Muslim, engage in a lot of charity. Do not be stingy. Point number 5 is patient. No matter what you are going through, be patient. Allah Rabbul Izzah says in the Quran, A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitan Rajim, Wabashir As-Sabirin, give glad tidings to the ones who are patient. Patience is the key to everything. No matter how painful it is, what you are going through, no matter how difficult it is, what you are going through, be patient. Wallahi, you will overcome and you will think, oh my days, I was in that situation a few years back, or a few months back, or a few days back, or a few weeks back. So patient, inshallah, and you will achieve success. Point number 6 is read. Read what? Read the book of Allah, the Quran. The book of Allah has got blessings. The book of Allah is a cure for any disease. The book of Allah will remove the devil, the depression, the anxiety, everything will remove it. Because Allah says it's a cure. So read in abundance. Allah Rabbul Izzah sends Jibreel alayhi salam down with a number, ayah number 1. And the ayah number 1, it says what? A'udhu billahi minash shaitan rajim, bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Iqra bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq, khalaqa al-insana min alaq. Iqra wa rabbuka al-akram. Read in the name of your Lord. This is how it is important to read the Quran. You read the Quran, Allah puts a barrier between you and those who don't believe in Akhirah. Unless you've got disease with yourself. Allah confirms this message I just said in the Quran. He says in the Quran, A'udhu billahi min shaitan rajim, bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim.
وَإِذَا قَرَأْتَ الْقُرْآنَ جَعَلْنَا بَيْنَكَ وَبَيْنَ الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ حِجَابٍ.
If you read the Quran, we'll put a barrier between you and those who don't believe in Akhirah. Unless you yourself don't believe in Akhirah. So read the Quran in abundance. The Quran has so much blessings. The Quran has gems, which is, it's overwhelming when you go through it and read it. Allah says in the Quran, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وهذا كتاب أنزلناه مبارك. And this is a blessed book, we've sent it down. So this book is blessed. Don't take it lightly. It's blessed book. Now imagine there's an evil person near you and you keep on reading daily and having the yaqeen. The evil person will flee from you because you are steadfast. You're reading 2 pages every day, 3 pages every day, 4 pages every day, 5 pages every day, morning and evening. You will see the outcome of it. Everything of yours will open, blessings. So read the Quran. Listening, no problem. But reading is more beneficial to you than anything else.
وآخر دعوانا والسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.